Ooh. Suspensions failed on both cars. Ooh. Alright, we're going to have to look at our manufacturing things and what looks like it's going to fail. Really love the Japanese GP is earlier now. Makes more sense that it's early. Just to let you know, it seems that the tension between Liam Lawson and Jan Suman has improved. Your intervention clearly helped the situation, so thank you for getting involved. Think a final meeting with them to talk it through, get everyone back to normal. Arrange a meeting. So their affinity's going up, his aggression's going down, and his mentality's going up, so that's good. Alright, so... definitely needs suspension done, right? And it's gonna be a while before this suspension is gonna be available. So, I think we just need to get two of them. We'll have a spare one for Suzuka. So on our cars, let's swap that out. Painful that it happened on both cars at the same time. Both my drivers don't like their engineer, and I can't sign a new one because without giving him your whole bank account, you won't be able to sign them because counter offers is not working. Oh no. Oh dear. Okay. On the floor in 2 days, and then we might look at just popping out another couple of front wings. Okay. Hospitality done. Is that underfloor completed or what? Oh no, it's another 8 days. Oh, okay, so it'll be ready the day before. Yeah, but we do have one now. I'll figure out what to do. So let's get this underfloor swapped to the new design. And then in 3 days' time, when these two are done, we can see how the next stage of the underfloor will look. Yeah, we'll continue our scouting of our free agents. And then I think we've got 2 days until those designs are done. Okay. And I do have solid engineers. I have Lambiasi and Botsy. Interesting. And yeah, I guess how do you make it so that your drivers have a better affinity with their engineers? Okay, side pod and chassis both done. So let's have a look. So we're getting a new front wing in 11 days. So maybe I risk it with the front wings on manufacturing. Let's have a look designing. So we want to put all our time in the underfloor again. more races, that's all. I think Botsy and Leclerc would have would like each other. It's his engineer in real life, but no Yates. Oh dear. So we'll again have that as our lifespan, so you know, airflow sensitivity all the way down. We do that. So that's getting us, again, massive gains in high speed. Sounds right for Ferrari. Drivers who retired from the F2 feature race in Spa. Villa Gomez, Martins, Colapinto, Behrmann, and Marty. Meant to be getting up to start my F1 manager, but I'm enjoying F2. Kind of sad I'm missing F2. Alright, let's do that. I'm gonna do intense. It's gonna take the same amount of time. It's gonna cost more. But I'm hoping, like, this is sort of banking it for next season. We might hold off on that until we get a suspension done, which is in 3 days. Oh no, this is the old suspension, isn't it? So maybe what I'll do, let's throw that extra engineer in there for now. Knock a day off there. So what have we got coming? We got not much coming until Suzuka for us to do. Now let's have a look at our powertrain. Four gearboxes. Is it time to start juggling sort of our gearbox and that? Okay. Ooh, that's some big gains on braking there. That's what we like to see. Things are going up. All right, so we done well to have them so that they were rested coming into this. There goes Fittipaldi. 6 retirements. Wow. And not a lot of them are fairly big names too. Just chuck that into car building. Car building doesn't take too much. There's then we'll get rid of a couple of these. I think that's okay for there. Now I'm just thinking, if we've got a race here, Antonelli's running in second at the moment behind Vershaw. Nice. I think we can assume that there's a race here. So we need this rest level to be the same as this rest level, which it's not. So let's get rid of a couple of these. Actually, we'll get rid of this one. What? Pressed it twice, it didn't click. Actually, maybe I can leave that. Yep, okay, so that's fine, I think. Aaron versus Hadjar versus Bordoletto, the top three of the standings, are battling each other for seventh. Ooh. Alright, so overall, our chance of mistake is going down, but can't. So maybe I switch this to this, because we want. Yeah, that looks a bit better. So car building a little bit better. Chance of mistake a little bit better. Pit stop time is fine. I think that's okay. All right, now where are we here? Let's continue on. Achieve targets. Mandatory activities. Okay, so does that mean I've got to do more sponsorship stuff now? So let's do the scouting. I think we've done all the technical chiefs, so let's get. Those ones done. Ah, okay, so it's to sponsor plan here, right, okay. Mandatory one. So we got the energy drink cameo. Driver marketability is slightly down. That's fine. We don't want that one because that's driver performance. Almost a big crash from Maloney Hauger. Hauger gave him no room. Let's go sponsor event. Facility effectiveness would be down. We're definitely not doing that. That one probably would have been better to know before I did my pit crew thing. I could have balanced that. Chuck that in. Factory would be less effective. I think we kind of need the factory at the moment. Wonder how much it affects it by. Because this one doesn't quite get us to the engagement thing, right? So race day appearance I don't want to do. Post-race debrief is staff performance. That gets us over the line. I think I might do that one. I think that's it. So we got 2 days, so the other underfloor should be complete. We got it on both cars. Yeah, manufacturing, so we got... We got front wings coming. Oh, we got our engineers back? No. That. So we got the front wing, which we can do after Suzuka. Closey 19, thank you for the follow. Appreciate it. The underfloor, we're fine with one, because that's getting us more more expertise. Front wing. I don't think we've done a rear wing design yet, have we? Enjoying the content? Oh, I'm glad to hear it. And yeah, thanks for stopping by. And hopefully, it's a little bit interesting for you. Okay, so let's bring this down. So we want probably the 3 to 5. I think airflow sensitivity. But this isn't going to be about cornering. This is the rear wing. This is about our top speed. So that could help us. Do normal. We'll just put on one engineer. Let's see what we can do with the other engineer to help. We knock a day off there. Which doesn't really help because that just brings us out in the middle of the Chinese one. Got 2 days off there, which gets us before Miami Guard. So let's. No, I don't want it on the underfloor, do I? Maybe I do want it on the rear wing. Okay. Yeah, manufacturing. That'll be done in 6 days, which means after that we'll do the front wing because they're about to fail. But we've got chassis or side pods. The chassis is huge. Huge on that. Side pods, not quite as much. So I'm thinking chassis. Let's get two of them to start with. We'll have one for China to go to Liam, and then the other one for Miami. I don't mind that. Top three in the standings are now 1, 2, 3 in the race. Interesting. Doesn't tell his entire strategy here, does it? Expected pit stop count, 2 stop, okay. I think we do the 20th. Car performance is 19th. Not 100% confident on that yet. Thank you, Stream Elements, coming in clutch right at the end there. Hopefully no one saw that link or clicked on it. I think that's good. And I'm probably just going to keep on that one as well. We're going easy with Hadjar. Still see the link, thanks to Better TTV. Yeah, I use that as well. But hopefully you're smart enough to click on it.
And it welcomes us back this weekend. Get ready for exhilaration and speed with the Japanese Grand Prix.
I feel sorry for anyone that clicks on those links. Because there are some streamers, like younger streamers, that maybe don't quite have the internet nous to be able to understand that it is such a scam. Rain, as far as the eye can see. Oh my goodness, okay. Although it says practice one, predicted weather, clear skies. There's a soft, hard, soft, medium, soft. If it wasn't raining. I'll say hards. Maybe free practice one is not going to have rain. Now, we haven't put our reserve drivers out yet, so they're both going to get a run in FP1 this week. I'm not going to do it every week, but I reckon every few races I should do it. Yay. Track details. So a little bit damp towards the second half.
Russell's edging.
What's up, Otis? It's gotta be Otis. It is Otis. All right. Let's go. Rayma and Jean. Got F1 24 yesterday. So the proper F1 game, not the F1 manager. Crawford, Drogovic are in. Was also in, as well as Porsche. Oh, in the... Yeah. It seems like the game does that a lot. So... Yeah. The driving one? Oh, nice. Nice. I've enjoyed it when I played it. I haven't played it for a few weeks now. Just had some other games that I've been playing. Not worried about track climatization here, so we can bring him in. Minor floor damage, it's a brand new floor!
I keep you updated, okay.
Yeah, V-Carb, both of the Japanese drivers, nice.
How does it feel?
Can't believe I got floor damage. On my brand new floor. Oh no. Okay, let's bring that up. Let's try that. Gives us something to start with. Well, not quite as good with the tires, are you, Gene? What a way to start off your F1 debut campaign. I can't believe we've got a damaged floor already. Oh, I just realized the rain's about to come and the track is going to get damp. Let's see what happens. We've got to go out now. It's not going to get dry for wet for 11 minutes, which puts us about here. So we can probably get a couple of bits of feedback on these hards before. Before the rain does get here. F1 24 is alright. It has a solid handling, but career and my team are getting a bit stale. Not much they can do about it, to be honest. It is what it is, like, yeah. I think, there's not a lot you can do with it. I like the couple of little tweaks that they had to the my team stuff.
Pick up some numbers.
Put them both on aggressive, see if we can get some more heat in the tires.
Copy.
Hoping to get two bits of feedback before I bring them in to put them on enters. Because they need to keep introducing new features and tweaks, otherwise no one wants the game. Yeah. Oh, okay, we got our two. Can we get three? Before we hit a millimeter of rain. Okay, yep. Probably we can't hit four. We'll go both in.
Okay.
Let's see what happens. Jeans had a spin.
Now we're through the last turn here. And the rear just lets go.
Yep, just out onto the strip.
To help those tires.
The F2 car feels atrocious. What are you doing? Are you doing a career of some sort, Otis?
We saw that.
Okay. Still pretty bad. You still can't see the weather from here though, can you? No. We're on a set of enters. Car setup. Action up there. That's too far that way. Let's bring that in. Yeah, let's try that. Let's try that. Took a driver career. Did 3 F2 races, then just simulated the rest because I wasn't enjoying it. Now I've done an F1 race for Williams and the F1 car feels good. We had a weird feeling in the Codas games. It was the worst in F1 22. Yeah, they probably don't put as much effort into the... the F2 handling model and stuff. Okay. Switch the tires, run plan up to 30 again. So we're optimal on traction, that's where we want to be there. So somehow we've got to get our cornering up without affecting our traction too much. That doesn't look too bad. That still looks optimal, and they're within their ranges now. Remember when this year F2 cars got released, and they'll feel different because different regs, or it'll just be visual. You don't really hear much about regulation changes in F2. But then I don't really follow F2 as much. They probably talk about it in the races more. Damp to the end, maybe a little bit of dry weather, right? Dry track right near the end. Okay. Wonder how many bits of feedback we can get. Who is Gene behind the friggin'? One of the Alpines sticking close. Surely it's not Ocon. Gasly struggling in the wet. Okay, any change to. So I reckon dry. We'll have some dry running right at the end. To make the cars essentially look more like current F1 cars. Not sure if they made them more ground effects as well. Yeah, well, I guess F2 needs to be similar to F1, doesn't it? Alright, come in. Not too bad. 89% isn't too bad. I'm just gonna throw that set of hards back on. We're very close there. 93%. Everything's just a tick off. So, I'll do the same. So, if it does go dry, we might just go out for a fast lap on the hards. Final lap. Paul Aaron's engine's gone and the podium is gone. No. Otis, I was going to have Paul Aaron in my team here, but he wasn't available as a driver for me to have. I was devastated. go one push lap each. Probably gone a bit early with Jean because she was so far back, but that's fine. Hadjar wins again. That's unlucky for Aaron. The only thing that mostly changed with F2 reg changes and such is the top speed downforce due to the new wings, but beside that, it's still the same F2 car with a toe on the same tyres and rims. So Hadjar, Portoletto, and Crawford for F2. Okay. Right. Predicted weather, light rain, and it's starting us on inters, and kind of inclined to do a Williams. And give my number one driver the new part. The rest of them sent O'Sullivan, Vachon, Maloney, Miata, Cordiel, Antonelli, and Dirksen. Well, Antonelli ended up ninth because of that pit stop issue. Alright, so looking at this, so wing angle 13.5, wing angle on this one is 12.5, tells me that we've probably got to go at least that way, one, and then ooh, maybe not. Easier for us to fix this. Let's try that. So I couldn't really get these lined up the other way. And this one's interesting. Everything to go that way because it can't go the other way, so let's just lock that one tick in, see what comes of it. Yeah, weather, keep an eye on it because it's going to get drier towards the end.
Yeah, okay.
You're up and down. It's right on that borderline. It's going to be a pain.
My bad, guys.
I don't want him to run wide. There's too much danger for bringing over of damaging the underfloor again. Aaron's title hope is fading after runs of poor results in the last few races. There's still race remaining, but can't afford to have bad results like this during a critical period. So who's leading the championship now then? Hadjar. Interesting. Uh-oh.
Oh, we've had a crash. Here we are then, reaching turn 13. Oh, that's where they hit the wall. And that's one surefire way to put a dampener on your weekend.
Here's this weekend's budget.
VSC. Watch your data.
Copy.
VSC ending.
Yep.
Copy.
Budget cap taking a hint. Here comes the official beginning of the growing pain period. It's been a struggle the whole time. What do you mean? I guess he's really struggling in the rain. What? He's on hards, that's why. He's freaking on hards in a freaking 1.4 mil wet track. What is the weather currently doing? So we'll have to go back out on these enters, I think.
Everything okay?
Happy with that.
What does he think? 72%, I think we got backwards. Kind of inclined to let him run until here for the track climatization, because that's growing quite quickly. I know, but to add up more damage to it, yeah, it's not been a great weekend. We've lost an underfloor, we've lost a chassis, we've lost a front wing, and we've lost suspension. Because everyone's flooding out right now, aren't they? Really, all we're doing now is just getting track knowledge. As soon as the track goes dry, we'll bring in Lawson. Yeah, also the spin from Gene. Yeah, it's not been good. Alright, things are starting to dry. We're holding about a mil 20. We're gonna have to come in because of the tires pretty soon. So, might do that because it's only a 43-second change. We're gonna have a few laps left. Use a set of softs, I think. Me, who just lets them drive for 40 laps in FP1 and practice 2, and then only does the setup in P3. Oh, I like sort of tweaking my setup and getting it right. Give it a sec before I let him out. Just once we hit this 5-minute mark and it drops. Used to, but after 4 manager games, now I only do it in practice 3. Yeah. By the time I got to the sort of end of F1 Manager 23, basically what I did, I would sim the session, then I would tweak my setup, then sim the session, tweak my setup, sim the session, change my setup. Like, well, actually you can't change it after the third one. Oh, you can change it into quality, but yeah, I sort of got to that point. But it's a new game, same mechanics, but it's a new game. So I'll leave it.
Temperatures are dropping.
I think we got one bit of feedback right at the end there. I'm pretty sure I heard it. We got heavy rain for qualifying. Engine, ERS, and gearbox, all gone. Wow. The ERS is the painful one. That was a good crash? Oh yeah. Okay, car setup. We did get optimal there. These are all within range too, so I can't really go anywhere with that one. So we're gonna keep on going. Starting us on mediums. Which you're probably fine with. But I do expect some rain. Actually, what does it say? Clear skies predicted, so maybe it's just going to be medium. We've got 40 laps in, because if we do manage to get like an optimal one, I'll probably run him to get that track climatization. Still on track there too, so maybe the same sort of things on mediums. He just needs to run out like almost the whole session, so. If we could just let Hadjar just run the whole session and just. That would be fantastic. Nope. Not happening. So much for clear skies! Oh dear. Just had to spend over 40 mil to repair my cars for the next race. Oh no.
Yeah, I f***ed up, sorry.
Another run wide. It's not been great for us this weekend so far.
Yeah.
Actually, looking at that, maybe it gets up to wet there, but it's going to be mostly intermediate.
We got drops.
Yeah.
The panic in his voice. We got drops.
Dropping.
Yeah, we'll bring him in. Swap him over to enters because it's just gonna ramp up real quick now. I think.
Dropping, no worries.
Might do that for Lawson as well. Just get them both in. Get them on enters. Get them on the right time. I think they're still enters. They move the line for the wets. It's only wets above 4 mil now, I believe. Okay. Still looking good there, so it's just a tire change really. So we're going on to those U set of inters. Run plan. It's 99 and not 100, yeah. Oh, come on! Speaking of... Oh, that's brutal. Not 99, 97, but one tick away. One has to go that way, and then that has to come in like that. That's a 4 minute change. I don't want to do a 4 minute change. I need him to get track climatization. Ninety-seven is going to be enough. I think what I had probably would have got it to 100. But I just don't have the time. 4 minutes of running time is just, it's too much. So we're still looking at enters all the way to here, and then it's dry to the end. None of the heavy rain they were talking about seeing. Yet.
All good?
Optimal. Fantastic. We've got a 100. So that's one that we'll save. Maybe in quality. Yeah, I don't like to change it too much in quality. Because you can only change the front wing, I think, after Parc Fermé. It might be too much of a risk. I might go away from my 97%. 97% is pretty bloody good. It's gonna be so bad with Hadjar. Probably doing that probably doesn't keep him out any longer, does it? Oh, the heavy raining quality. Not changing stuff. Yeah. Sorry.
Copy.
Okay, so the rain didn't last as long as we thought, so once we get to 1 mil, we'll bring them both in.
Shrugging a bit.
Okay, copy.
That's gonna be a moot point.
Slow down.
Yeah.
Update on tires.
Right, both of our tires are shot. I think this is the lap to bring them in. First things first. Save that. There's Suzuka 1. All right, so change over back to those mediums. 16 minutes of running left, so we'll just go 16 laps. I know it doesn't quite do the math, it's a minute 30 a lap, but close enough. Car setup is fine. Confirm. Claire, his mentality is so low after 3 DNFs in a row, which none of them are his fault. That's unlucky. Is in. those mediums. And again. About as good as we can do. Vitality status is a bit broken. His stats went down by 15. Maybe it's not broken. Maybe that's the way it's meant to be. Maybe, like, they're putting so much emphasis on mentality that... Yeah. You're basically your Perez now. Oh, let's get that up to standard so he gets those tires warmed up. Perez stat. That's basically how it feels with Perez. Like, he starts the season well, has a huge slump through the middle, and then finishes the season well. And Red Bull seem to think that that's okay. Alright. That's disappointing.
Qualifying is coming up, and the drivers will be ready and raring
big
old to
fat
go.
Rain.
Remember, we
Perez is just made for street tracks, it seems, not circuits. Another five at the end, but even
Q2,
the street tracks this year,
Q3
he hasn't done well on.
Will set the top 10 positions.
Garun, how do you think Logan Sargeant's going to be feeling at the moment?
Looking at the lap times, we saw a real lack of pace from them in practice.
Yeah,
they
never
looked quite comfortable with the setup.
Still surprised he has a 2-year contract.
New for qualifying, if they want to get past Q1.
What does today have in store? Only time will tell.
So yeah, he always comes back stronger after the summer break, he says. Alright, so it's just giving us straight wets. Now the question is, do we do this? Because that would be the change, I think. Yeah, let's do it. Screw it. Why not? First thing you want to do is see what the weather's going to do for this session. So it's going to come down to a damp track. Yeah. The fact that McLaren's are so much stronger now. So we want to be doing a lap here. Right, so we're looking at maybe, what, a 2-minute outlap-ish. So we need to be going out in, say, 8 minutes. Say 7 minutes. Let's go out at the 7-minute mark. So it'll be the 11-minute mark to get the best, which will be on the inters. Yeah, Quali has the heavy rain. I think it's going to be acceptable here for Inters. Push back a little bit. The weather radar's not great. I think it's too early. I still think here's the sweet spot to come out to get the best. I reckon about here. Oh, let's push back a little further. Yeah, I reckon now's our chance. Gotta be wary that the weather center is not accurate, so it could be way different. Yeah, my weather center is terrible. Let's see. 2.6 mil. No, this looks like a pretty good, pretty good management right there, if I do say so myself.
slowing up.
Yeah, the cost cap glitch? I haven't heard of that, but I haven't looked at any glitches or anything like that. I just play the game and whatever happens, happens. Like, I had people come in. Oh no, they're getting... The track's in too good a shape. It's in too good a shape, they're gonna get a good run. I think we just go back out on the same set of enters. It's going back up. It's going back up. Oh no! Oh no, my strategy! No! No! It didn't ramp back up like I was hoping it would. I was looking at the cost cap after I created my team and I was like, why is 80% used already? I have to be careful before I got fired after the build. Oh no, I should check mine then. Why is Hadjar got a grid penalty? I know he crashed, but he didn't crash into
anyone. 53 figure of eight laps around this historic circuit.
Anything can happen at Suzuka, as Kimi Raikkonen proved in 2005. The Finn battled all the way from 17th to win. Will we see a similar show of will and talent today, I wonder?
Managed drivers had no crashes, so no extra costs. Oh, that's lucky.
Suzuka is a high-speed, high-downforce circuit with unpredictable weather. Drivers need to have total trust in their cars to make the most of this challenging figure of eight lap. Welcome to race day. And before we get down to it, last minute checks are being made.
Okay, so light rain, 10 place grid penalty because of all the... Maybe it was that. Maybe it was the grid penalty because I changed the engine, ERS, and gearbox. Okay, so let's have a look. Do we still need to go into here? A couple of spots where it might get to dry. But essentially, yeah, we're looking at inters the whole way. Odd that it had that current pace set there like that. I don't really mind the glitches, eventually they'll be patched. Exactly, yeah. That's never a game breaker for me, unless it's a game breaking bug. Like the game crashing or, you know, literally just unplayable. Now I'm gonna go two ticks down, because normally you can make up fuel in the wet. Well, you could on F123, if I'm managed 23, so I'm gonna assume you can in this as well. And we got the car set up to 100% for Hadjar as well.
Well, it's great to have you with us, folks, as we settle in for the weekend's Grand Prix action. Now, this could be an important race for Pierre Gasly.
I don't think there'll be many expecting them to mount a challenge from P19, but I wouldn't discount their chances.
Given the UE5 crash.
Oh,
that sucks. Must admit, I didn't really have any problems with crashing.
Get ready.
It's the Japanese. I had had some UI glitches, which were game breaking.
And it's lights out, and away we go.
Lawson side by side with Ocon as we get into the S's. Ooh. Ocon's given us no room there. Bottas has damage. And Ocon has just squeezed us off the track and taken the place. Track is dry. We're not expecting it to stay dry for long, are we? No. Alright,
Copy.
Another technical fault for Joe, and it's orange too.
Just keep going forward.
Interesting. You've had no crashes with F1 Manager 24. I'm glad that you it didn't have the same issue from 23 for you. Bottas has damage, Joe's got mechanical faults, and we just need to stick with him and take advantage of it. I was about to say, it seems like Leclerc really has no pace now, but then he bangs in the fastest lap for the sprint pole. Of course the horses are behind me. Well, hopefully he has a good sprint race and he gets some of his mentality back for you. Okay, let's focus in on Lawson, because he is close to Joe. So what are we going to do? We're going to let him attack. High overtake.
Just keep your hands up.
Joe just got no power along the straights here. Bring that back down. Great work from Lawson there, taking advantage of the situation.
Gap is 1.9.
Bring that down.
Copy.
Yeah, we're gonna get Hadjar up to the back of Joe so we can do the same for Hadjar. You remember Hadjar's back in the old spec car because he doesn't have the upgraded cornering speeds that Lawson has. Gotta be careful, I don't wanna
push the tires.
Track is dry. It's gonna get damp again. I'll just use the battery with Hadjar to see if that alone can get us within striking distance of Joe. Lawson looking good. clear of Joe. Hadjar, put him on high overtake now.
Okay.
See, a little bit of battery left, so we should be able to get past him. It's just a matter of where can we get past him. I love this checkerboard of my team. 1-2 Ferrari, 3-4 Red Bull, 5-6 McLaren's. 7, one, your team, 1-2. Ferrari, 3-4, Red Bull, 5-6, McLaren, 7-8, and then you've got 2 Aston Martins, right in the top 10. That's pretty consistent. Come on, Hadjar. Need to get past Joe quickly. So he looks up the inside, but Joe cuts him off. Hadjar switches back to the left. He's going to stick his nose up through. Squeezes Joe, gives him no room. Makes the move. We got a yellow flag.
Very good job.
Hadjar takes Joe is not the yellow flag. Hülkenberg lockout, let's have a look at that.
Now, by the looks of things, we're at turn 15 now.
No one behind him, though, so it looks like he's probably...
Now, they did leave it very late.
...gonna just be able to get back on the road without too much fanfare. 11th and 12th of the Mercs, Albon and Marty. Kick Sauber still lasts by 3 seconds. Oh, no. Yeah, let's put him back on medium. And, hoping that we just pull away from Joe, if possible. Would be nice. Crack is about to get damp again, and should be damp for a little while. Yeah. Like Lawson's just a bit too far back, but I don't really have much of a way to close that gap. Try and use our battery a little bit and see if we just get onto the back of the group. At least Albon to Merck is a realistic transfer. Yeah, we know Bottas has damage, so he may be a bit of a sitting duck for us. Don't really want to push with the tyres because we're sort of at that cutoff point, so. Alright, let's speed up a little bit, see how things play out. Still not enough options here, I don't think. Speed it along. Hadjar still not sort of breaking away from Joe. Could be that Joe's just got a bit better handling in the rain, potentially. I have a Hülkenberg and Ocon in Kick Sauber. It seems instead of taking Hulk's seat, he's joining the force. It's been coming for years. Finally, they've ended up at the same team at the same time. Lawson just can't quite get close enough. Well, Joe's had a lockup. That's good for Hadjar. That's given him some breathing space. Let's see what happens to that gap if I go top up. Russell had enough of Merc and joined Alpine on your save. Interesting. Perez has come in very early for a pit stop. Oh, oh no.
Sorry.
Yeah.
Oh, Lawson was doing so well. But a bit of a mistake. Just got on the power a little too early.
My bad, guys.
Came back and Lawson spun. So what you're saying is it's your fault, Sean. Red Bull in this game did what most people want, sack Perez after one season. Oh, it's let's put it back to neutral. All right, let's just let this play out in quicker time. Sergeant pitted early. May have to go a lap early with. Like a lot of the AI going on a two-stopper. Do you think you'll change drivers next year? I know it's very early to say. I'd prefer not to. I want to try and keep these guys for at least a couple of years and develop them, if I can. Rebel will discuss Perez's future in a meeting tomorrow. I think a lot of what, Perez's future is going to... I think he's dead.
And here we've got a yellow flag.
Multiple cars too.
Now we see this was at turn 15. Pushing a bit too hard at this point, and the impact on the car is
Sergeant.
Clear. Who was at
Sergeant
fault?
Did it to me. Definitely be God damn it. Pointed. Not even my fault.
And for the crew watching on in the garage, that really must have been a hard one to take.
Oh, car retired. Sergeant out as well. But I'm ahead of Sergeant because I'm further up the road. Yeah, we've seen it. We don't need to watch it again. Dr. Killian, appreciate the follow. They should have left Sergeant in the pit lane. Oh, man. Wait, is this a full safety car? So I should probably come in while it's a free pit stop. And then try and extend my tires.
Box.
Copy box.
And Sergeant gets a penalty. Are we even going to catch the train before we are just good. Good. All right, now. We've got to get these tires to the end if possible. Virtual safety car. Uh-oh. It's all happening. It's a shame for Hadjar, it is. Goodbye. It is. Not his fault, either.
VSC. Porsche Delta.
Copy.
Be good for us. Let's put that on conserve, and harvest. Let's check his replay. Oh, that's what we did in free practice.
I hit the wall, guys.
Rear wing gone.
And not much that the team can do about that one.
Apparently Bull is the Alpine fashion statement. Ocon's retired.
Yeah,
this will definitely allow Zhou to catch up to the back of the train this time. Oh no, it's only virtual safety car. Condition change to dry. But it's still borderline, isn't it? What's everyone's tires look like? Definitely a few people that aren't going to be able to make it to the end. Show a mile behind.
Just watch out. VSC ending, VSC ending.
So we got heaps of fuel, so let's use a bit of that.
Copy. DRS enabled.
DRS enabled? I guess it is dry.
Okay, copy.
Come on, buddy.
Copy that.
Lawson's trying to put pressure on Bottas while we can, while we're there. Gotta be careful we don't shred the tires though.
Temps are okay on the surface.
Not quite close enough to go down the inside there. When I have to race the rain, I always under fuel and I always get a safety car from -2 to +5. It seems that way, doesn't it? Oh, Lawson's looking to go up the inside. He's gonna make the move and he's gonna make it easily. Let's immediately bring this down.
Okay, copy.
Put him back to medium. Great move from Lawson there. Here's your lighter car. Ooh, Bottas with DRS. Well, we both got DRS, so Lawson's able to use DRS to keep ahead of him. Hoping that this rain starts to pick up. It's gonna make a meal of our tires. We may need to come back in for a new set at some point. If this is the case. Yeah, Bottas going past Lawson there. Why have the pace to go with Bottas, I don't think. Should be fine, seem to have decent tire preservation. Seems to be going okay. Let's see, as we get a bit of DRS here, will Lawson have enough space to get up ahead of Bottas? Immediately bring the DRS, the ERS off. Back to medium. Get that place. Can always put it on conserve for a couple of laps if I need to towards the end. Your tire preservation is 17th best, I think. Mine's not too bad either. Tsunoda's had a lock up.
Let's take a look at the replay. Along the straight here. And the car fails to respond. But that's just the risk you take. The later you leave it.
He had a lock up on the, in the middle of the straight. Speed it up a little bit. We got 22 laps to go. Oh, more cars have crashed.
There's a yellow flag now.
It's all happening. The other Alpine. There's got to be some front wing damage there.
It's not going the way the team had hoped today.
Not good for Alpine, that's for sure. Let's have a look. Yep, missing the wing. Track's going to be a little bit drier for a few more laps. Gasly might come away with a penalty out of that. If I start on the same tire as the AI and I get a pit, they still have 20% more tire life than me. Might need to focus some of your design stuff on tire preservation. Bottas has got past Gasly. Question is, can we get past Gasly? Let's watch this gap, see if it comes down.
What do you think about track conditions?
It's ever so slowly coming down. The question is, will it come down quick enough? On a little sort of little flash of yellow there for a second. The signs. Ooh, I'm near the top too. I did do a little bit of research, but I forgot that using CFD and wind tunnel hours during research gives you more percentage back. So I'm going to use that trick for my next reg change. Okay. Feel like we're probably going to need another set of tires towards the end if we get a safety car option. Yeah, let's slow down. A few people coming to the pits there. Still on inters, so no one's thought that the track's dry enough for anything else. Bottas comes in. We are now firmly behind Gasly. So we are gonna try our very best.
Let's go and get them here quicker.
Yeah, copy that.
Put some pressure on him and get past.
Okay,
get past. Good defense there, good defense. And I on purpose didn't do research on three parts because there's a tiny bug going on.
Don't worry,
man. The AI right now is doing research. I didn't want to become too overpowered. Fair enough.
segment a little bit with the France.
I could do it.
Just focus, mate.
And we'll get him here. Nice and easy. Bring that straight back down.
Looking good, mate.
We are going to be little sitting ducks for those behind us. Tsunoda goes past, but that's alright, he's on very, very fresh tyres. Yeah, they've actually broken away from Gasly, which is good. See if we can just go on light for a couple of laps. Joe, mechanical fault. Oh no. Poor Joe. And a lockup for Joe as well. New patch is going live in about 3 or 4 days, so it fixes it all. That'll be good. Yeah. I'm not playing too much of it. I'm sort of just playing a little bit here and there, so hopefully I won't be too far in that I get too much benefit from any bugs. Haven't got the damp track that we expected through this race. Trying to get us on this last, on this set. Finally the track changes to damp. Finally. Couple of places here.
Copy that.
But we'll be ahead of Gasly and ahead of Joe. Wouldn't worry too much about that, you'll be fine. They're not sure if the new patch applies to already made saves. Sometimes it does not. Yeah, I guess it depends on what it is and what needs to be fixed. Alright, 17th, not bad. Not bad. It wasn't the greatest weekend for us, but
sometimes I think you just have to accept that it's not going to be your race.
This really is going to be an incredible disappointment.
And next race weekend's going to be and an opportunity missed. Next little while's going to be interesting as we
Max Verstappen can
get
add another podium parts. To his already impressive.
So Leclerc is first. First race where he hasn't won, but still managed to get on the podium, so that's good for him.
And a lovely show of sportsmanship to conclude proceedings here in Japan. Well, Karun, how do you think they'll be feeling in the team garage at the end of that?
Well, it was a bit of a mixed
sprint
bag.
Sprint race weekend next.
Something
oh, no.
Went their way, but others
China's
didn't.
A funky track.
I think their
it
main
is.
Target now will be finding some consistency for sure.
Is it this proper format? So it's got like all for today, as practice, sprint quality, sprint quality race.
The next round as we head to Shanghai for all the excitement of the Chinese Grand Prix.
All right. So, Piastri coming fourth. Sainz ended up down in fifth. Lance had a decent race up into sixth. Perez down in seventh. That's pretty ordinary from him. And then no Racing Bulls in the points, but 11th and 12th. So Aston Martin just keeping ahead of them. Hadjar very unlucky. Not his fault. So if we look at the standings, so Sainz still trailing Leclerc at the front. Verstappen jumping up two places with that victory. Lando getting some good points is equal with Verstappen. And then the Aston Martin's ahead of the Mercedes. As we go down, Racing Bulls are the only other team with points, both 2 points for the drivers. And then we look at the constructors. So Red Bull chipped away a little bit at the Ferrari lead, not a lot, still a substantial lead. Can't believe it passed him because Sargent decided he had enough of Hadjar in front of him. Exactly. And yeah, we're not going to feature in here at all. So we still get our payout, even though we DNF'd, which I'm happy about. We got that because we finished 10 meters further up the road than Sargent. That's amazing. All right, we are gonna finish off the stream there because we've done two races. I'm not gonna do anything here. I'm gonna start the next stream, going through all the design and stuff then, which will probably be on Tuesday, so in a couple of days. What am I doing after stream? I'm heading off and going to get some dinner and stuff, mate. I'm not going to be in the call. Let's see if any of the community is on. So Daily Phil is playing some F1 Manager. What's for dinner? I'm not sure yet. I haven't had a look what I've got. Oh, that's right. I've already got someone lined up, Sean. All right. Thanks everyone that came out. Appreciate it. Had a blast. Hope you all have a fantastic rest of your day. And yeah, we'll see you in the next stream.